He is the new sheriff in town, swept into office on the heels of a scandal that would eventually send his predecessor to prison.
But the top cop in Plaquemines Parish is about to face his own tempest. A harassment complaint filed with federal watchdogs and the threat of a lawsuit. The fallout from an affair that now has one woman both hurling accusations and defending herself against criminal charges.
In the past several days, a federal complaint was filed against Plaquemines Parish Sheriff Lonnie Greco and some of his top staff.
And we want to note the complaint includes allegations not suitable for all audiences. WDSU I-Team investigative reporter Travis Macko live with us right now at 6 with who is making the claims and why she says the public needs to know about the relationship she had with the sheriff, Travis.
Camille, this former employee says she was mistreated and forced to resign after the affair ended. Now, she's taking steps through the federal system, making some hefty allegations with documentation she claims can back up what she's saying. And we should warn you, some of the material in this story is of a mature nature. 4 stars on his shoulder. In Plaquemines Parish law enforcement, no one outranks Sheriff Lonnie Greco.
We have a great community.
He's the area's top cop, elected in 2011 after former sheriff Jeff Hingle resigned from office, eventually pleading guilty to bribery charges. Greco vowed to clean up the department's reputation.
I am very honored to be your next sheriff.
And while Sheriff Greco's abbreviated first term in office is almost over, he's up for re-election next year. It has not been without some controversy. Many of the former sheriff's top staffers were fired or chose to resign, and new people were ushered in. One person hired by Sheriff Greco, this woman.
What was your job at the sheriff's office?
I was a grant director.
A widow, Carol Ruggles, was hired after she served on Greco's campaign.
He was my husband's best friend.
And after a few months, Ruggles says she entered into a different sort of relationship with Greco, who is married. She says the two took trips together and spent a lot of time with one another.
We were always together. Everybody knew it. We were always together.
In fact, in September, Greco went public with the affair, admitting to the weekly Plaquemines Parish Gazette that he had made a personal indiscretion. There was no indication that the affair involved Ruggles. Greco simply said, "It's humiliating, but it happened, and it's a private matter." But no longer. That's because last week, Carol Ruggles filed this complaint against Greco and the sheriff's office with the Louisiana Commission on Human Rights and the EEOC. The Equal Employment Opportunity Commission is a federal agency that investigates claims of unfair and hostile work environments based on, among other things, race, sex, and disability. In the detailed filing, Ruggles says she was discriminated against because of her sex and suffered retaliation stemming from her relationship with Greco. She claims she was forced to resign and harassed. And in her filing, Ruggles included a mountain of text messages as evidence.
Some of them are very, very graphic. He sent me a picture of his penis. He sent me a video of himself masturbating.
There are dozens of explicit messages, all submitted as evidence in the EEOC filing. And while Ruggles confirms the relationship was consensual, the complaint says the messages were exchanged while she was an employee working for Sheriff Greco.
It's unbelievable.
Legal analyst Robert Jenkins says that could potentially be a problem.
Normally you just have the complaint and you don't have much more, but she seems to have more than the complaint. She has evidence to back up the allegations that she's saying, and some of the evidence is just unbelievable.
Ruggles says when she tried to end the relationship, the backlash kicked in, and she claims she was forced to resign the day after she broke off the affair.
And that's when this situation takes an even more unusual turn. About 2 months after she claims she was forced to resign, Carol Ruggles was arrested and charged with doctor shopping, basically trying to illegally obtain too many prescription pills. State police confirms to us they made the arrest, but only after the case was started and referred to them by the Plaquemines Parish Sheriff's Office. Do you think your arrest was retaliation
Absolutely.
From ending your relationship with the sheriff?
From ending the relationship and trying to discredit me for when everything begins to come out.
And it appears the sheriff knew civil or federal action may be coming. Last month, as we were investigating the allegations, we asked Sheriff Greco about the matter. His office sent us this statement. He cited pending criminal charges against Carol Ruggles and possible civil litigation. He mentioned the likelihood of a lawsuit, even though, at that time, neither a lawsuit nor an EEOC complaint was filed. Ruggles told us she does plan to file a harassment lawsuit before year's end.
And generally, you file your complaint with the EEOC, and they look at it and determine whether or not they think some violation has taken place. And this is what she has here. Not only is she going to file, go further with this, but the deposition in this thing is going to be incredible. It's just unreal with the support that she has with the text messages.
We reached out to Sheriff Greco for a comment once more after reviewing the EEOC complaint. His spokesperson told us, under the advisement of an attorney, they would not be commenting. Ruggles says the people of Plaquemines Parish, who have gone through one corrupt administration, have a right to know what's going on inside this building.
I fear for my safety. I fear for the safety of my kids. I want people to know what happened.
Carol Ruggles has retained well-known criminal defense attorney Eric Hessler to represent her on the drug charge. He is asking a judge to dismiss the case based on a lack of evidence and alleged improper investigation. Also, she has a second attorney, Jennifer Rodriguez, who is handling the EEOC complaint. Norman, Camille.
All right, thanks, Travis. And one of Carol Ruggles' attorneys tells us that the district attorney has not yet accepted charges of doctor shopping. A court date is set for December, and we'll keep you posted on developments with that matter, as well as the matter with the EEOC complaint.
Turning now to